What's up, guys? Sam Adams here, and today we are going to be talking about something that is obviously going to be a big part of pretty much every gamer's fall lineup, and that is Star Wars Battlefront, and the fact that Peter Moore from EA said that there would be no Star Wars campaign in the new Battlefront game because players would probably not play that. According to some statistics, there would be quote-unquote very few players that would actually play the campaign of a Star Wars Battlefront game, and I thought that I would talk about my opinions on that for just a minute or two. So obviously there was data taken and compiled to kind of come to this conclusion that people wouldn't play the campaign of this game, and I assume that that would be from other EA titles like Battlefield, primarily Battlefield actually, and of course Battlefield Hardline absolutely tanked whenever it came out earlier this March. The player base is still kind of strong in the multiplayer aspect of it on the Xbox 360, PlayStation 3, and other newer generation consoles, but as far as PC goes, that is pretty much a dead game, and the single player campaign of that was supposed to be extremely story driven, and it just didn't deliver. I played the first probably 2 hours of it, and it just didn't grab me enough to fully pull me in and experience the rest of that game. And of course, if you've been following the Battlefield games for the past couple of years, there hasn't really been a breathtakingly fun campaign since, I would say, Battlefield Bad Company 2, which of course is a famous game in the franchise itself, but at the same time it had one of the best single player campaigns of that entire franchise, and Battlefield 3 didn't deliver, Battlefield 4 was kind of lackluster, and of course with all of the launch issues, that's when a lot of people would be playing the single player campaign, and I think that that's really where the guys over at EA kind of got the thought in their mind that people wouldn't play the campaign of any kind of first-person shooter that they normally would put out. Now, at the same time, I could see EA kind of trying to recreate the success that they saw with Titanfall whenever it came out a couple of years ago, and of course, this was a huge title in the Xbox One because it wasn't exclusive, and there wasn't that much story to it. There was that kind of first establishment of a background story, and then they just kind of went off and did their own thing with fast-paced action gameplay, and of course, the wall runs and a lot of parkour style maneuvering and things like that. That kind of stuff really made Titanfall shine, and of course Titanfall 2 is rumored to be going multi-platform, and the guys over at Respawn really know what they're doing with that new franchise, but Titanfall to me was one of those few games that really just made success on its own without really having an amazing storyline or a gameplay that was really out of this world. There was just something about the entire atmosphere of Titanfall that really made gamers enjoy the game, and I think that that's kind of the thing that EA is trying to do with Star Wars, because not only do you have that giant name carrying the game, you also have the opportunity to really make some awesome gameplay with jetpacks and various kinds of Jedis that you can use, and there are just a lot of things going for Battlefront that they might not really need a single player campaign. Like I said, that giant Star Wars name is definitely going to be carrying Battlefront, and that is probably a good thing, and that's one of the reasons that I don't really think that they needed a single player campaign in the new Battlefront, because Star Wars in and of itself has enough story to keep it going. You've got the stories of Han, you've got the stories of Leia, you've got the stories of Luke, you've got the stories of Obi-Wan and Qui-Gon Jinn and all these other Jedis and characters from the Star Wars universe that you automatically bring to mind whenever you hear the word Star Wars. And so with that kind of stuff already in your mind, there really isn't a need for the campaign, because Battlefront is kind of about adding background information to your kind of Star Wars brain catalog, if that makes any sense. It's not about experiencing something that's going on with a lot of story-driven content and a huge campaign that really drives the game and drives a new kind of storyline into your mind. It's about just kind of living and experiencing the Star Wars universe as a whole, and I think that that is where the Battlefront franchise really shines, because it's not so much about making a story as it is about glorifying the main story of Star Wars itself. Another thing that could have made this kind of a giant mess in a way is that the new movie is coming out, and of course Star Wars The Force Awakens is hitting this winter, and a lot of us Star Wars guys are really excited. It's one of the few movies this year that I'm actually going to go out and see in the theater. That's just how excited for this new Star Wars movie I am. But if Star Wars Battlefront had kind of went that route of a single player campaign, there would have just been too much storyline for this winter. Obviously people are going to be focusing on the Force Awakens storyline, people are going to be playing Battlefront, and people that go see The Force Awakens might see a new Star Wars game on the shelf and go ahead and purchase that. And had there been a single player campaign in that game that was kind of contradictory to the new movie, then there would have just been a lot of confusion and people would just kind of been overloaded with Star Wars backstory. At least that's what I think. At the end of the day, what's really cool about how EA is treating Battlefront at this point, it's that the franchise of Battlefront is being completely separated from the new Star Wars movie and kind of the Star Wars universe as a whole, I guess you could say. I kind of see Battlefront, like I said, as a more detailed and in-depth look at the universe of the Star Wars franchise rather than just, you know, a branch off of it itself. It's just more detailed. It really lets the player feel these battles and really experience what's going on in the movies, and that's where I really want EA to take this franchise in the future. The guys over at DICE are doing wonders with this game. The new engine looks beautiful, and the fact that they took the models from the original movies and brought them into the game is going to just kind of just immerse the gamer in realism, and that's something I'm really looking forward to experiencing when Battlefront comes out later this fall. So there you guys have it. I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you did, drop me a like down below and comment what you think about this entire no campaign thing. Should there have been a campaign? Did Peter Moore kind of address the issue well? Let me know what you think in the comment section down below. And of course, if you are new to the channel or you've never seen any of my other content, be sure to check out some of my other videos. I upload new stuff 4 or 5 days a week, so there's always something new on the channel when you drop by to watch some videos. And as always, I want to thank each and every one of you guys for watching this particular video. I'll talk to you soon. Peace, and I can't wait to see some Star Wars this fall.